Social justice activists from across Texas came to the Capitol to urge lawmakers to pass police reform bills. They rallied Thursday in support of the George Floyd Act. The bill would ban officers from using chokeholds. It would also limit qualified immunity in police brutality lawsuits. Maggie Glynn looks closer at the arguments for and against the bill.
We stand together to say enough is enough.
On the same steps of the Capitol where protests broke out in early summer last year, community activists from across the state rallied to support House Bill 88.
We're here today fighting for the George Floyd Act to make sure that we are not losing another black life to politics, to white supremacy, and to also archaic laws that protect the officers, not just the communities they're serving.
House Democrats filed the bill.
It's dealing with things like qualified immunity, certain tactics that police officers use.
After hearing hours of personal stories here outside the Capitol, this same group is moving inside the Capitol for testimony in support of the George Floyd Act.
Let's stop these public lynchings.
They included George Floyd's close friend, Travis Kaines.
I didn't see my little brother die. I see my little brother get murdered.
And dozens more. But the bill has become partisan. Republicans show hesitation after law enforcement agencies raised alarms. The Texas Police Chiefs Association only opposes part of the bill, the removal of qualified immunity, which provides legal protection to officers making split-second decisions on the job.
If you remove qualified immunity, you're going to decimate the law enforcement profession. And your officers are going to leave, perhaps by the thousands.
Still, the group agrees. Reform is needed this session.
Now is the time to make substantive change. We just need to be careful stewards of said change.
Maggie Glynn for State of Texas.
Maggie, thank you. George Floyd was killed in Minneapolis, but he's originally from Texas and has family in Houston. Last year, Governor Abbott met with Floyd's family and attended his memorial. At that time, he voiced support for legislation to prevent something like this from ever happening in Texas. But Abbott did not include the bill on his list of legislative priorities. A high-profile hearing gets shut down, shutting out people who came from across the state to speak. How a big mistake blocked a battle over new rules for Texas voters. Texas makes all adults eligible to get the COVID-19 vaccine, but the move has some people worried.
If we open up the state to everybody, where does that leave those of us who haven't been able to get our vaccine yet?
What the state's doing differently to help get the vaccine to Texans who need it most.